video is about my hair. Now, this video is about, remember, Shit Stained Sammy, Wally Wrong Note, Bobby Badcord, to review. You know, if you're playing for a singer, okay, first of all, you have to know the words of the tune. Right? You can't do it correctly if you don't know the words. I remember every time I had to do it in L.A. or in Vegas, good arrangers would put the words there. Say rubato, you know, body and soul. You have to play this first chord. Where are they going to sing? You know, there's no fret markers. Also, like, okay, Rip Misty. Okay, so you have to give a singer here. Wally Wrong Note goes. Now, how's the poor singer going to find her fucking note or his fucking note after that chord? Wally Wrong Note. Carl Badcord. Bobby Badcord. No, they don't even put, fuck that, that's the melody note. Don't give him that. Fuck, you're too hip. There you go. Sammy, every gig he does, he leaves a shit stain somewhere. Getting an argument with the owner, you know. Shit stain Sammy, he's good like that. Grammys, Django Reinhardt, man. If we say anything negative about Django Reinhardt, my God, people might as well consult somebody's mother. He breaks a lot of fucking guitar players besides him. Thumb Down guys, man, they're having a fucking field day with that. Good. I like that. The more thumbs down I get, the better I know I'm doing something right. And you know, some of these guys, they're very insulting sometimes. I block them from the channel. So they still see it. But they don't know that their posts are not showing up. And I'm not seeing them. Nobody is seeing them. They're pissing in the wind. The piss is hitting them in the face. Their own piss. I love that tune, Django. Please, enough with Django Reinhardt. Give me a fucking break. I wrote it out. The melody in the chords. I listened to it to YouTube now. John Lewis wrote it. Now this second chord. Pretty sure he played a B flat minor. I changed the bass note. I like this one better. G minor 7 flat 5. C7, I altered it. Nice tune. a good corkscrew tune, listen to Joe Pass. Anything he plays. Joe Pass and Herb Ellis did this. This is the chords they played. Play that with Buddy Rich, one of the best charts. I forget who wrote it. Also, you know, young people, don't smoke and, you know, don't drink. Drinking is fucking bad news. You make stupid decisions when you drink. A lot of bad shit happens to you when you drink. So, stay away from that shit. You don't know if you're an alcoholic until you try it. And start drinking, whoa, I'm an alky, fuck, now you're screwed. I remember one time when Buddy Rich band, guys like Buddy Rich stories, lead trumpet player was his last night on the band, a guy named Charlie Davis, fantastic lead trumpet player. And so guys were doing shots and beers. I was 19. I drank a couple shots of 151 rum. Couple, who knows, I lost count after the fifth one with beer. That's a combination. You gotta experience that. Fuck, boy, I had a hangover. It lasted a week, you know. And Buddy, in his kindness, called every fucking tune that I had a guitar solo in, and I had to stand up. I couldn't even lift my. I was walking around like this, couldn't lift my head up. And then in between sets, somebody told him what happened to me, and then. One of the few times he was nice to me, he says, just sit there, kid. Play like Freddie Green. Try not to stand up. I wouldn't trade that experience for all the money in the world. Also, my stint at the Hilton in Las Vegas had a great boss. You know, band leaders, usually they can't play. They suck. Not this guy, Jimmy Molidor, man. What a monster musician. Could play all the saxophones, of course. Flute, clarinet, and check this out. Bassoon. He could play jazz solos on the bassoon. Monster. He had some funny sayings he used to say. How was that food? Tastes like ground dog dick, Jim. Have some strawberries. Just go for your neck. I hear from him from time to time. He plays some jazz gigs in Vegas sometimes, a couple other places. Still going, sounding better than ever. Ground dog dick. Man, what a funny guy. Hey, I collect Social Security because of him. Those people I played for never paid into it, except him. I don't want to tell him, he might take it back. Now, Muldoon. Even when I went to L.A., all his friends, everybody knows me, plays so good. Everybody gave me a chance to do something. Wally, wrong note, Wally. And, you know, I once had a fucking guitar teacher one time. I didn't take lessons with him, but I had a student that was taking lessons with him. And the guy had a habit of, he never shut the fuck up. He just fucking talked and talked. I've seen students come out of his fucking lesson with like tissue paper in their ear, with blood was coming out of their ear. Motherfucker would never shut up. And you know, anybody mentioned, oh yeah, I know that guy. Well, I know him well. And then he mentioned this guy's name to somebody else, and you see people gagging. Ah, like the Heimlich maneuver. Heimlich maneuver. Oh, that motherfucker. Yeah, I knew him. Tell him I said hello. Fuck, never again. Tried that one time. Whoa, people were yakking or throwing up. All right, I don't like Stardust. I played it too many times. A well-known guitar player, and I don't know, he thought he was a jazz player, but not really. Good cocktail guitar player, not bad, you know. It was so old-fashioned, man. Oh, Jesus Christ. Every time I can't play that tune, I get nauseous. Nothing against the tune, Hoagy Carmichael, but kind of soured me on that fucking tune. Beatles tunes, not my thing. I'd rather listen to it than play it. Well, some people, I hear some people do some nice stuff with their tunes. I'm just not a fan. Here comes more fucking shit now. Wow, you don't like the Beatles. Get a lesson in the back of a lunch meat store. You get, Paulie Brazut, Bobby Baloney. The lessons cost $5 and you get a bologna sandwich on white bread. Shit stain Sammy. Sammy the shit stain. That's all I got for today. See you tomorrow. Oh, you know what? I you know the Grammy, that shit? I got part of that video and I put it on Facebook. My God, boy, I'm trying to get banned from Facebook, but didn't work. I got so many likes. It was unbelievable how many people hated that fucking debacle, or is it debacle? Protein. What's the correct pronunciation? Debacle? Debacle. I think it's debacle. I like the way that sounds. Stravinsky was into words. Really loved words. A lot of his operas, he liked the libretto, it's called, you know, for what the words to put people sing. Lyrics, but they're not really lyrics. And he went for things that he liked the rhythms of what the spoken word made, the sounds that they made. True genius. See you tomorrow.